Welcome to Dr. Martin Head and Neck Radiology. In this video, we will address the radiological identification of three anatomical variants of the jugular bulb: high jugular bulb, dehiscent jugular bulb, and jugular diverticulum, through the analysis of two interesting radiological cases. A 50-year-old female patient with a history of chronic right otitis media. A computed tomography of the temporal bone was performed as requested by her treating physician. The observed findings are as follows. Axial section of the right temporal bone in bone window. The jugular bulb is visualized at the level of the basal turn of the cochlea, a finding suggestive of a high jugular bulb. More superior axial section. The internal auditory canal is observed and the jugular bulb remains visible, confirming the presence of a high jugular bulb. Coronal reconstruction. A high jugular bulb with a defect in the sigmoid plate is evidenced, a finding compatible with a dehiscent high jugular bulb. A 39-year-old female patient with left pulsatile tinnitus. A computed tomography of the temporal bone was performed with the following findings. Axial section in bone window of the left temporal bone. A high jugular bulb is identified, accompanied by a sac-like lesion protruding anteriorly into the middle ear cavity, a finding compatible with a jugular diverticulum. High jugular bulb, a congenital vascular anatomical variant in which the superior portion of the jugular bulb extends up to the level of the floor of internal auditory canal or above it, generally at the level of the basal turn of the cochlea. It is more frequently observed in patients with poorly pneumatized mastoid cells. It is usually an incidental finding, and otoscopy is normal. Dehiscent jugular bulb, a congenital variant in which the high jugular bulb protrudes into the middle ear cavity through a dehiscent sigmoid plate. It may be associated with pulsatile tinnitus. On otoscopy, it appears as a bluish vascular lesion visible through the tympanic membrane. Jugular bulb diverticulum, a congenital vascular anomaly characterized by a sac-like or digitiform protrusion originating from the jugular bulb. It is generally an incidental and asymptomatic finding. In symptomatic cases, pulsatile tinnitus, it is usually associated with a dehiscent jugular bulb. If you find this topic interesting, I invite you to check out our video on the radiological findings of peritonsillar abscess. I have left the link in the comments section. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this content, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, like the video, and leave a comment with your thoughts or questions. Your support helps us continue creating valuable educational content.